Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about execute SQL task, result sets. In our last to last video, we have discussed about result sets. So we have total four type of result set. First is none, then single row, then full result set, and then XML result set. So here I would like to discuss about none, full result set, and single row. So let's start with none. So here, as we have discussed, it will not going to return anything. So I have a scenario where I would like to insert record in a table by using execute SQL task. So go to on SSMS. So this is our table. Initially, we don't have any data in this table. Once we will execute our SSIS package, then data should be inserted in this table. So go to on SSDT. And here I would like to add one more package. Then I wish to rename this package with execute SQL task result set. Then I need to drag and drop execute SQL task. Then double click on this execute SQL task. So here, as you can see, we have SQL statement. So I would like to create OLEDB connection type. Then we need to select the connection manager. So click on new. Here I have already made the connection. So I would like to use that one. So click on OK. Here, as we can see, SQL source type, which is direct input. In SQL statement, I would like to write our insert statement. So as I have already typed the query, so go to on SSMS and need to copy this insert statement and go to on SSDT, paste that query, then click on OK. So we have done, and in our result set, it's not going to return anything. So that is none. Now click on OK. So we have done our package. Now we can save it and execute. So package executed successfully. Now go to on SSMS to check the table. We can press Ctrl R to refresh this table. Three rows have been inserted in this table. So this is for none. Second is single row result set. So here it will return a single row. Doesn't matter number of columns. Column may be one or more than one, but a row should be one. So go to on SSDT and here double click on this execute SQL task, and this time a result set should be single row. And in our SQL query, I would like to write a select statement. So this is our select statement, and it will going to return server name and current date and time. So it has two columns with a single row. So I can copy this select statement and go to on SSDT, and here we need to paste that query. Now click on OK. As we have discussed, it will return a single row. So we need to go to on result set tab, and here we need to create two variables. First is for server name and second for the current date and time. So this is for server name. So I would like to write SER and value type should be string. Now click on OK. And in our second, I would like to create one more variable, and this is for current date and time, and value type should be date time. And here we need to specify a default value. So I gonna use default value. Now click on OK. And in result set name, we need to specify 0 and 2. It would start from 0, then 1. 0 would be refer for column 1, and 1 will be refer for column 2. Now we have done. Now we can click on OK. We have done our execute SQL task. To check the output, we have to use a script task. So go to on common, and here we can drag and drop script task, and need to connect with execute SQL task. Now double click on this script task, and here I would like to pass two variables which we have created. First for the current date and time, and second for the server name. So this is server name. Click on OK. Click on edit script. So here we need to write our code. So I would like to use message box dot so. So here we need to write DTS dot variables, and I would like to use server name first. Then dot value dot to string. So this is for server name. Second, I would like for current date and time. So I can copy and paste, and here we need to replace our variable name by current date and time. So we have done our package. Now we can close it and click on OK. Now I would like to execute our package. So here, as we can see, this is our server name. Now click on OK. And this is our current date and time. Now click on OK. So it looks good. In full result set, it would going to return full result sets. Maybe single row or more than one row. Maybe single column or more than one columns. It could be anything. So go to on SSDT. And this time I would like to delete our script task. Double click on this execute SQL task. In our result set, I would like to use full result set. And instead of SQL statement which we have written, I would like to select whole the table. So I would like to copy this. Once we execute, then we can see we are having three columns and three rows. So go to on SSDT, and here we need to paste that query. Now click on OK. Go to on result set. In result set, I would like to remove these two and add a new, and this is for zero. Here I would like to create one more variable, and this variable should be object type. So obj value and type should be object. Now click on OK. Again OK, because it would going to read more than one rows. That's why we need to use object type variable. It will hold the data which we are getting from our query. So I can execute. It looks good. So here we cannot use script task directly to check the data. We have to use for each loop container. Once we will discuss about for each loop container, then we will see the output for this full result set. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.